Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the fifth session of the chapter Units and Measurements. In our previous class, we had seen about accuracy, precision and errors. So while explaining the types of errors, we had seen systematic error, random error and least count error. So those are the types of errors we have. And also, I told you about the methods of expressing the errors. There are three methods of expressing the errors. What are those? Let us write it one by one. First one is absolute error. Absolute error. Second one, relative error. Relative error. Then the third one is percentage error. So these are the types of expressing the errors or methods of expressing the errors. So in our previous class, last class alli nodiddu naavu types of errors astane. What are the sources of errors? Yaak error barutte ondu measurement alli anta naavu last class alli tilkondiddu. Ee class alli henge naavu errors anna measure maartivi or how what is the quantity of error ondu measurement alli eshtu quantity of error ide anta naavu express madodukke ee mooru method na naavu balustha idivi. So these are the methods to express the errors. First one is absolute error, the second one is a relative error, and third one is a percentage error. So let us look at one by one. Now we will see what is this absolute error is. Imagine we have an object and I wanted to measure the length of this object. I wanted to measure the length of this object. Let A is the length of it. E one the object the length A and ankolana, and I need to measure this length A. So I will use an instrument to measure this length, and I have measured this length n times. Ondu sala matra nan measure maartta illa, I am measuring it so many times. Let us say that the first measurement is A1. Modalne measurement na A1 anta kariyana. The second measurement is A2, third measurement is A3. So up to n times I have measured the same measurement. So this A1, A2, A3, A4 up to AN, they are all called the measured values. A1 is the first measurement, A2 is the second measurement, A3 is the third measurement, AN is the nth measurement. Now let me take the mean value of these measurements, A mean. A mean means the average of all these measurements. How do you take the average? A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus etc. up to AN whole divided by N. Sum of all these measurements divided by number of measurements. This is called as a mean value. So I have told you in the last class itself, the mean value is taken as true value of a quantity. If you take the mean value or the average value, that mean value is called true value of that quantity. A1, A2, A3 up to AN are the individual measurements or the measured values. What is this A mean? A mean is the true value of that quantity. Now, let me write this delta A1. Delta A1. I am writing delta A1. What is this delta A1? Delta A1 is equal to A1 minus A mean. Delta A1 refers to A1. Delta A1 is equal to A1 minus A mean. See, this delta A1 is the difference between the first measurement and the true value. Delta A1 is the difference between the first measured value A1 minus of this A mean, which is a true value. Then if I write delta A2, how do you write this? A2 minus A mean. A2 minus A mean. Similarly, if I write delta AN, this becomes AN minus of A mean. Correct? So delta A1, the delta AN becomes AN minus of A mean. This delta A1, delta A2, next we have delta A3. Similarly, up to delta AN. So these values are called absolute errors. They are called absolute errors. If I see the first one, delta A1 is equal to A1 minus A mean. This is the first measurement and this is a true value, or this is a measured value, first measured value, and this is a true value. So the difference between the measured value and the true value is called as an absolute error. So absolute error for the first measurement is this one. For the second measurement, delta A2, A2 minus A mean. So this delta A2 is the absolute error of the second measurement. Delta AN equals AN minus A mean. So this delta AN is the absolute error of the nth measurement. So how do you define the absolute error now? It is the difference between the measured value and the true value. Measured value and the true value. Not only this, you have to add one more thing here. What is that? You should take the magnitude here, mod of delta A1. Similarly, this is also modulus and this is also modulus. What do you mean by writing this modulus symbol? Even though if this difference becomes negative, you should take that as positive. So absolute error is always positive. It cannot be negative. If you consider this one, A1 minus A mean, A2 minus A mean. If you find any negative values here, you should consider that as positive. So that is what the meaning of this modulus is. Now let us give a proper definition for absolute error. I am writing the definition of absolute error. Let me write it. What is absolute error? It is the magnitude of difference between measured value and the true value. Yes. So how do you define the absolute error now? It is the magnitude of. Why do you write magnitude here? Magnitude means this modulus. Even though if the value comes negative, you should consider that as positive only. So it is the magnitude of difference between measured value and the true value. So measured value and the true value. So these are the keywords. So it is the magnitude of difference between the measured value and the true value. This is what we know as absolute error. If you consider this, this is the first absolute error with respect to the first measurement. This is the second absolute error. You will get third one, delta A3 as A3 minus A mean. Up to AN if you write, then delta AN becomes AN minus A mean. So these are the absolute errors. Now, let us write the mean values of all the absolute errors. The mean values of all the absolute errors. What is that mean value of absolute error? Delta A mean. I am considering delta A mean, which means the mean values of the absolute errors. How do you write this? Delta A mean is equal to first one, this one, delta A1 plus this is delta A2 plus up to delta AN whole divided by N. So we are just taking the average of these absolute errors. So delta A mean is equal to delta A1 plus delta A2 plus up to delta AN whole divided by N. So this is called as mean absolute error. This is mean absolute error. So why do we write this mean absolute error? Means if you measure any physical quantity, how do you represent that physical quantity? So when you measure any value, any measured value, so that measured value should always lie between A mean plus or minus delta A mean. Means the value A lies between A mean minus delta A mean. So this value A lies between a mean minus delta a mean, which is lesser than a mean plus delta a mean. Means any measurement, so that will always lie between a mean minus delta a mean or a mean plus delta a mean. This a mean plus delta a mean, this will be the general representation of a measured value. Suppose if I measure a quantity one time, only I am measuring that quantity one time, how do you represent that physical quantity? So if a is the measurement, if a is the measurement, then that measured value is expressed as a plus or minus delta a. If another measurement, b is another measurement, how do you represent this b? B is represented like this, b plus or minus delta b. So any value, any measured value can be expressed in this form, a plus or minus delta a or b plus or minus delta b. Now we will move on to the second way of representing the errors. So the second way is relative error. Relative error. Now let us understand what is relative error. So I told you that a mean, so if I measure the physical quantity n times, the mean value is considered as a true value of that quantity. So this a mean is equal to a1 plus a2 plus etc up to an whole divided by n, and we have written what are the absolute errors for these measurements. What is that absolute error? Delta a1 is equal to a1 minus a mean, delta a2 is equal to a2 minus a mean, and similarly delta an is equal to an minus a mean. So these values are called as absolute errors. We have taken the mean values of these absolute errors, which is represented as delta a mean. That delta a mean is equal to, delta a mean is equal to delta a1 plus delta a2 plus up to delta an whole divided by n. So this is called as the mean absolute error. Mean absolute error is, so sum of all the absolute errors divided by number of measurements. So this is called as a mean absolute error. Now let us take the ratio of this mean absolute error to the mean value. We will write delta a mean divided by a mean. So what I have taken is delta a mean, which is the mean absolute error, divided by a mean. A mean is the true value of a quantity. So the ratio of mean absolute error to the mean value of that quantity, this is called as a relative error. So we will simply write the relative error as, relative error is the ratio of mean absolute error to the mean value of a quantity. For individual quantities, like if a is the measured value, if I consider a is the measured value, so I told you that the measured value can be expressed in this form, a plus or minus delta a. If I want the relative error of this a, how do you find the relative error of a? Relative error of a is written as delta a, which is the absolute error, divided by the true value, delta a by a. So this delta a by a is the relative error with respect to measurement a. So relative error, what is relative error? How do you define the relative error? Now the relative error is the ratio of, it is always a ratio. So relative error is the ratio of mean absolute error to the mean value of a quantity or a true value of a quantity. Iga onde measurement madirad nanu, I have taken a measurement like this a. A is the measured value. So nan helidini measured value heng represent martivi naavu, a plus or minus delta a. A andre true value, delta a antandre absolute error. So if I have this measurement, how do you find the relative error of this a? Edu relative error heng find out madad naavu, we take a ratio of absolute error, this delta A, divided by the true value of that quantity, delta A by A. So this is known as a relative error for one particular measurement. So if I have one more measurement, B is another measurement. How do you find the relative error of B? Relative error of B is just simply delta B by B, where delta B is the absolute error of B and B is the true value of that quantity. Let us write the definition for relative error now. Relative error. So let us write the definition for relative error. It is the ratio of this one. I am writing the definition with respect to this equation. So relative error is ratio of the mean absolute error to the mean value or true value of the physical quantity. This is about the relative error. Now what is percentage error? It is very simple to understand. So I have told you the equation for the relative error as delta A mean by A mean. So if I express this in percentage, or if I multiply this equation with 100%, we will get a percentage error. So percentage error is simply the relative error expressed in percentage. That's it. Let us write that. I told you that percentage error is the relative error expressed in percentage. Let us write that. Let us multiply this delta A mean by A mean with 100%. This is nothing but a percentage error. So percentage error is generally represented using this symbol delta. This is small delta. Okay, so delta A is equal to, this is capital delta, delta A mean by A mean into 100%. So this is about the percentage error. After calculating the relative error, if you multiply that with a 100%, you will get a percentage error. In this topic, we have learnt about what is absolute error, what is relative error, and what is percentage error. What is absolute error? Absolute error is the magnitude of difference between the measured value and the true value. Remember, absolute error is always positive. That is why we put a symbol called mod. Then, what is relative error? Relative error is nothing but the ratio of mean absolute error to the mean value or true value of a quantity. Or it is simply a ratio of absolute error to the true value of a quantity. And then if I express the relative error in percentage, we will get a percentage error. So this is about the methods of expressing the errors. Now we will solve a problem regarding this, then you can understand better. I will read the problem. So the same will be displayed on the board also. We measure the period of oscillation of a simple pendulum. In successive measurements, the readings turn out to be 2.63 second, 2.56 second, 2.42 second, 2.71 second and 2.82 second. Calculate the absolute error, relative error or percentage error. So this is the given problem. So we need to find what are the absolute error, relative error and percentage error. But they have given some measured values. Let us write what are the given things first. ಮೊದಲನೇದಾಗಿ ಏನೇನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಬರ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದೇ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಾಗಲಿ ಆ ಡೇಟಾ ಏನಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಾವು ಅನಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ತುಂಬ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಾವೇನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋಂಥದ್ದನ್ನು. ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋಂಥ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ 5 ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆಷರ್ಡ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೆಂಡ್ಯುಲಮ್ 5 times. ದ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಔಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 5 different ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್. Let us write it one by one. The readings are turn out to be like this. In the first measurement, the time period is found to be 2.63 second. And in second measurement, it is 2.56 second. In the third measurement, 2.42 second. In the fourth measurement, 2.71 second. And finally, 2.80 seconds. So these are the readings which are nothing but the measured values. Now, what we need to find here is, what are absolute error and relative error? Absolute error matha relative error na naviga find out martha hogbeku. So I told you that to find the absolute error, what we need is the measured value and the true value, correct? So they have given the measured values. All these five are nothing but measured values. First, we need to find the true value. Adar the true value na now first to calculate madbeku. Hege now for true value na calculate martivi. I told you that we have to take the average or mean value of it. Let us find the mean value of these measurements. T mean is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4 plus T5 whole divided by 5, because the number of measurements are 5. So this is T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4 plus T5 whole divided by 5. Let us write, or let us substitute the values of this. T1 is 2.63 plus T2 is 2.56 plus T3 is 2.42 plus this is 2.71 plus 2.80 whole divided by 5. Let's find this. So you can use your calculators to find what is the numerator. So if I find, or if I add these 5 values, what I will get is 13.12 divided by 5. So T mean is equal to 2.62. T mean is equal to 2.624 seconds. So if I round it off this to a second decimal, we will get 2.62 second. Okay, so we got the value of T mean. That is nothing but a true value. Let me write it here. So I have the measured values, and the true value is, this is T mean. The T mean is found to be 2.62 second. This is 2.62 second. Fine. Now I got the measured values, and also I got the true value. Now we should find the absolute errors. Absolute errors means the difference between measured value and true value. This is the first measurement. So delta T1 is equal to, delta T1 is the absolute error of the first measurement. Delta T1 is equal to T1 minus T mean. T1 minus T mean. So what is the T value of T1? T1 is 2.63 minus, this is 2.62. So the difference is 0.01. So the first absolute error, delta T1, is found to be 0.01 second. So we got the first measurement. Sorry, we got the first absolute error. Next, let us find delta T2 now. Delta T2 is equal to T2 minus T mean. T2 minus T mean. So what is the value of T2? T2 is 2.56 minus, this is 2.62. Now, if you take this difference, you will get minus. But I told you that while calculating the absolute error, we should consider the modulus symbol, correct? So here we have a positive sign, so no problems. So while writing this one, 2.56 minus 2.62 will give us 0.06 with a negative sign. But I told you that absolute error should be considered always as positive by putting this modulus symbol. Therefore, this becomes positive. So delta T2 is equal to 0.06 second. So we got the second absolute error. In the same way, we can find delta T3 and delta T4 and delta T5. Nan idana complete ag bariyak hogodilla, values kalna matra barkotini, you can calculate it. Okay, so delta T3 is found to be 0.20 second, and this is found to be 0.09 second, and finally delta T5 is equal to 0.18 seconds. So I got the values of delta T1, delta T2, delta T3, delta T4 and delta T5. So all these values are nothing but absolute errors. So now we should find the relative error for this. How do you find the relative error? So for relative error, what I need is the mean absolute error. So we need mean absolute error and the mean value. Correct? I have written the values of absolute error. So now we should take the mean value of this. Let us write that. So delta t mean is equal to, we know that we should take the mean values of all this. Let us write that. Delta t1 plus delta t2 plus delta t3 plus delta t4 plus delta t5 whole divided by 5. So delta t1 is 0.01 plus delta t2 is 0.06 plus this is 0.20 plus 0.09 plus 0.18 whole divided by 5. So if you do this one, what you will get is, I will write the final result. Delta t mean is equal to 0.11 second. So if you do this calculation, you will get delta t mean as 0.11 second. So now I got the values of delta t mean and t mean. To find this relative error, I have the values of delta t mean and t mean. Let us substitute that. Delta t mean is 0.11 divided by t mean is 2.62. If you find the value of this 0.11 divided by 2.62, what you will get it? 0.041. In your calculator, you calculator le madadaga nimge 0.108 bandirutte. So na ee value na hege bardidini antandre 108 na round off madadaga 0.11 barutte. So you should mark this one. So idu nimge gotagirbeku 0.108 ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ 0.108 ಬಂದಿರಬಹುದು. ಆ 108 ನ ನಾನು ಎರಡು ಡಿಜಿಟ್ ಗೆ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ 0.11 ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್, ಸೊ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ 0.0419 ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ 0.0419. ಸೊ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟಾ ಟಿ ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಟಿ ಮೀನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅ relative error. This is nothing but a relative error. So the value is 0.0419. ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಈಗ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಮತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೆ ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, 9 ಇರೋದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಈ 1 ಇರೋದು ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, 2 ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ 0.042. ಸೊ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ 0.0419, ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ 0.042. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಎರರ್. ನೌ ಇಫ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಎರರ್, how do you write the percentage error? Remember, relative error expressed in percentage means if you multiply this relative error with 100%, you will get a percentage error. Let us write that. So after multiplying 100% to both sides, so this left hand side is nothing but a percentage error. So this percentage error is equal to 0.042 into 100%. If you multiply this, you will get 4.2%. So let us write that. So you got percentage error as 4.2%. This is nothing but a relative error, correct? This is relative error. So relative error is this, and this is a percentage error. Okay, so in this class what we have learned is what are the methods of expressing the errors. So there are three ways of expressing errors: absolute error, relative error, and percentage error. And also, as an example, we had seen a problem. So we have 5 measured values, and for these 5 measured values, how do you find the absolute error and then relative error and then the percentage error? So that's all for this session. Thank you.